We have had 50 years of military rule, and during this 50 years, our education system has tottered. It has tottered badly. At one time, Burma was the country with the best education system in Southeast Asia. Our standards were very high, respected the world over.
Once the military regime had taken over, the lights went out one by one. The education system got worse and worse for two main reasons. One was that the government was no longer accountable to the people. Secondly, a dictatorial government does not want its people to think too hard. And that is why they did not put the right kind of emphasis on education. They did not want education as a means for sharpening people's intellect, as a means for increasing people's ability to analyze.
I have often thought that the saddest thing about Burma over the last few decades has been the lack of campus life for our university students. Campus life means a life in which young people can create their own world or make the world their own. They have the freedom and the facilities to do so. Our young people in Burma have not had this freedom for the last few decades. University life has been shattered.
Our young people have not known campus life for decades. The focus of the military government was on maintaining discipline, not on providing education. Young people gathering at a university campus were considered dangerous. They were looked upon as would-be demonstrators, young troublemakers who would demand the fall of a government. Of course, young people like to voice their opinions and also to oppose what governments do if they think that governments are not doing what they should be doing. But try to destroy campus life in order to keep our young people quiet is to destroy the future of our country. There are no residential universities in Burma. Added to this, hostels are not allowed to be built within the vicinity of universities. These are steps deliberately aimed at keeping our young students separated from one another, that they may not gather together and become a force for change, which young people need to be.
It was here at this school where opposition to colonial rule first took hold. It was here that Aung San edited a magazine before leading an independence movement. It was here that U Thant learned the ways of the world before guiding it at the United Nations. Here, scholarship thrived during the last century, and students demanded their basic human rights.
Education is the foundation of human dignity.
The most important thing for me about Oxford was not what I learned there in terms of set texts and set books we had to read, but in terms of a respect for the best in human civilization.
Democracy and democratic values have to be embedded in our education system if we are to make our society a sound democracy.
The future of this country will be determined by the education of its youth.